So the topic of the class is the radiant body. And we're going to talk a little bit about what we've understood and what we've learned, the concept of radiant body, related especially to Guroban Singh, and then a bit about Sant Sipahi, means soldier saint. So according to humanology, the yogic tradition, we have 10 bodies, or not just this physical body. And most of you probably know that, but just to briefly go over that, I'll explain it shortly. And if you have any questions, please feel free to raise your hand. First body is the soul body. That's you. That's the essence of who you are. That's the piece of Paramatma, or God within you. Second body, the next three bodies are related to the mind. Negative, positive, and neutral mind, different aspects of the mind. Then you have the physical body, which is your physical body, pretty obvious. Arc line from earlobe to earlobe for men and women both, and then women have a second arc line across their chest. Arc line is where your, it's like the meter of your aura. It's where your aura can be read, it's where your aura will draw its strength and where it will shine. Susing Sab said he used to read the aura by looking at the arc line and understanding the arc line. You look at pictures of the olden day drawings of Jesus, of Moses, even of all of the Sikh gurus, you'll see that they had a halo around their head. That's symbolically the arc line. But not just spiritual people have arc lines, everyone has an arc line. Some people's are bright and radiant, some people's maybe something less than that. But the idea is obviously strengthen and have awareness of that body. Then is the aura. The magnetic field that surrounds you can go in 9 feet in any direction when you're expanded and when you're at your best, like all of you are after 3 days of tantra. After the aura is the pranic body, which is the breath, subtle body, and then the radiant body. The radiant body is the last body, the tenth body. It's the most subtle of all of the bodies. What Susing Sab taught, what Yogi Bhajan taught, was the radiant body is when your electromagnetic field or your aura is completely expanded. Everyone has a radiant body, but again, everyone doesn't tap that and draw on it and allow it to work for them. The radiant body is when you're completely expanded and your aura touches its peak capacity and then the trim of it goes golden. That's the radiant body. The person who most in our lineage personifies the radiant body was Guru Gobind Singh. The radiant body gives you power of your projection and power of presence. Right? Anything that you need to say can be said without saying it verbally. Guru Gobind Singh was known by enemy and friend alike to have the most powerful radiant body. Whenever he walked by someone, they felt their life changed. A powerful radiant body gives you that presence. When you walk in a room, when you're standing, even in a crowd, you're recognizable. People feel drawn and attracted to the light that you're emitting, and that everyone can emit. But you have to tap that radiant body, and it's difficult. You use the breath, and you use postures, and you use chanting. There's so many different ways you can do it. Understanding and acknowledging that we have these 10 bodies and then strengthening the radiant body in this way gives you a huge responsibility because it's also, it gives you a presence. And we've had times, I know I dress like I'm dressed right now pretty much every day. And in America that's strange for people to see when you're in Whole Foods or a grocery store or something like that and someone walks by and they see you dressed like this. There's many different reactions you can get. But a funny one that happened to me recently was a lady who saw this big sword, she called it, which is just a little knife, actually, Gibbon, on the side, hanging on my side, right? And she said, "I'll wear those big knives? Why do you do that?" So this look on her face was so mean and so nasty. And she was just, she thought it was the worst thing anyone could do. So I took 30 seconds. You know, sometimes you just shrug it off, sometimes you want to engage with them, sometimes you want to laugh, sometimes you want to cry. But this time I chose to just say something. So I explained to her what it was very quickly. very briefly, and her jaw just dropped. And tears started coming to her eyes, and she said, I've never heard anyone explain that before. I didn't know why you wore those. Thank you for telling me, and maybe I should wear one too. She was really inspired by that. She felt that. This dress we have alone gives you that presence and gives you that ability to hold that space. The radiant body is probably, Sri Singh Sabra wrote a whole book on it. And the exercises we do today, you'll see, will give you such an experience of it that you never want to not have the ability to tap into that and to feel that in your life, because it can give you. You do have to have the touch of your radiant body. And that's what's most important, that's what the class is for, is to expand that and to feel that. No matter who you are, no matter how you're choosing to dress, if your radiant body is active and you've touched that and you live in that experience constantly, you'll be great and you'll serve people through your presence.